Now, we will see the next problem in this section. We have to prepare a composition table for Z7 star. Okay? And the operation that we are going to use is multiplication modulo 7. Now, Z7 star means I am going to omit the 0 element from that. So, what are the elements of Z7? The elements of Z7 are 0 bar, 1 bar, up to 6 bar. Right. But we are omitting 0 because of this star. So, what are the elements of Z7 star? Now, 0 is omitted. So, I will get 1 bar, 2 bar, 3 bar, 4 bar, 5 bar and 6 bar. So, these are the elements of Z7 star. And I am supposed to prepare a composition table for that. So, I will write the composition, the elements here. So, I will get 1 bar, 2 bar, 3 bar, 4 bar, 5 bar, 6 bar. Here also. And we will multiply the elements as our usual way. As discussed in the previous sections, I am going to use multiplication modulo 7. Means if 7 comes, actually 7 will never come, but 7 is equivalent to 0, 8 is equivalent to 1, and 9 is equivalent to 2 bar, and so on. So, this is the way I am going to do this. So, let me show you the first and the second line. So, 1 bar multiplied by all these elements will give you the same element. So, 1 bar, 2 bar, 3 bar, 4 bar, 5 bar, 6 bar. Now, let me show you the second line. 2 bar multiplied by all of them. So, 2 bar into 1 bar is 2 bar. 2 into 2 is 4 bar. 2 into 3 is 6 bar. 2 into 4 is 8 bar. But 8 bar is 1 bar. 1 bar. 2 into 5 is 10 bar. But 10 bar will become 3 bar. And 2 into 6 is 12 bar. And 12 bar becomes 5 bar. In this way, I will now complete the table. I will multiply 3 bar to this, then I will multiply 4 bar to this. All the time, I am going to use this equivalence that 7 will be 0, 8 will be 1, 9 will be 2, and so on. Okay, so we will complete the table now in a similar fashion. So, this is the table that I have completed. Okay, all of you should take out your own time and do these calculations carefully so that you will understand how to prepare this table. So, my composition table is now complete. Now, I will, in the second part of the exercise, we are supposed to find the inverses of 3 bar, 4 bar and 5 bar. So, 3 bar inverse, so let me write element and let me write the inverse here. Now, what is, how do you find the inverse means? A bar multiplied by B bar should be equal to identity. Now, who is the identity of this group? Obviously, this person, 1 bar, is the identity of group. Because if I multiply 1 bar to all of them, I will get the same elements back. Right? So, it means that A bar multiplied by B bar has to be 1 bar. So, we are asked the inverses of 3 bar, 4 bar and 5 bar. So, what is the inverse of 3 bar? 3 bar multiplied by which person is giving me 1 bar. So, I will go in 3 bar and search for 1 bar here. So, here I will get that 3 bar multiplied by 5 bar is 1 bar. So, who is the inverse of 3 bar? 5 bar is the inverse. If I will go for 4 bar, 4 bar multiplied by 2 bar is going to give me 1 bar. So, this means inverse of 4 because 4 bar into 2 bar is 1 bar. So, this means that inverse is 2 bar. And what is inverse of 5 bar? Now we know that 3 bar into 5 bar is 1 bar. And therefore 5 bar into 3 bar will be also 1 bar. You check here. So 5 bar into 3 bar is also 1 bar. So inverse of 5 bar is 3 bar. So this finishes our exercise of finding the inverses of 3, 4 and 5. You can also find the inverse of 2 bar if you want to. You can also find the inverse of 6 bar. See, inverse of 2 bar will be 4 bar. And inverse of 6 bar will be 6 bar itself. So, 2 bar inverse is 4 bar. And 6 bar inverse is 6 bar. So, So this now completely finishes our exercise.